Song.
Baja hure mana Sri Nanda Nandana Abhaya Charana
Para ti,
Sri Nanda Yogana.
Ashivana Tala Mala
Tala 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 Ashivana Tala Mala
Ajabu Hari Pada Siri Tire
Ajabu Hari Pada
Siri Tire Ajabu Hari Pada Siri Tire Ajabu Re Mana Kirtana Smarana Vandana Pada Sevana Dasya Re
Shravana Kirtana Smarana Vandana Pada Sevana Dasya Re
Bhujana Shakhi Jana Atmani Vedana
Bhujana Shakhi Jana Atmani Vedana
Bhujana Shakhi Jana Atmani Vedana Govinda Dasha Vilasha Re
Govinda Dasha Vilasha Re
Govinda Dasha Vilasha Re
Govinda Dasha Vilasha Re
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare Usually he used to sing. Can you explain the meaning in brief? If we follow any kirtan of our Goswami, Bhaktivinoda Thakur or Uttam Thakur, Govinda Das, anyone, if only one song, will be liberated Krishna Prema comes. So we should try to sing, but also to realize and follow.
Om Ajnanam Timurandasya Jnanam Jana Salakaya Chaksura Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah. Srila Gurudev has ordered me to try to explain this song in brief. This is a very beautiful song by Govinda Das. Govinda Das is an eternal servant of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And as Srila Gurudev said, our Srila Prabhupada used to sing, he is a Bhayachara Naravinda Bhaktivedanta Swami. And he used to sing this song to Bhaja Hare Nanda Sri Nanda Nandana Abhaya Charanaravindare. Govinda Das is telling his mind and teaching us how to speak to our minds. O mind, please worship the lotus feet of Sri Nandanandana, the place where there is complete fearlessness. So Gurudev said our Srila Prabhupada used to pray to his own name, Nandanandana's lotus feet, Abhaya Charanaravinda, and weep by such praying. So, O mind, please take shelter of the fearless lotus feet of Sri Nandanandana. Always give me the association of sadhus, great saintly persons who are surrendered to Sat, the supreme Satyam Param, Krishna, and the more supreme Satyam Param, Srimati Radhika. When Krishna was in the Rasa Leela, he was singing up to the fifth note and the gopis sang up to the eighth note. So Krishna congratulated them with sadhu sadhu. So those who are in Radhika's line as her assistant maidservants, they are the real 100% sadhus. And Govindadas, as a servant of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is praying to his mind to take shelter of such sadhus by whose association and by following whose instructions one can cross over the ocean of birth and death. He complains to his mind that because you, O mind, are absorbed in material desires and anxieties, you give me sleepless nights where I'm suffering bitter cold and heat, and you force me now to serve very bad masters just for the purpose of gaining flickering happiness. You've engaged me in the service of wicked persons who don't have my benefit at hand, but who have their own selfish motives in hand. And I've become toys in their hands because of my desires for material existence. So please, as Srila Raghunath Das Goswami prayed, please, right now, you're engaging me, you're burning me, you're extinguishing me and incinerating me by engaging me in taking the very hot, urine-like water of the hypocrisy and deceit, of the donkey of hypocrisy and deceit, which is trickling on me and burning me. Please resuscitate my very being and engage me in the nectar-like Harikatha of Radhika and Krishna under the guidance of the sadhus. Then he's admitting to his mind, O mind, what use? I've taken shelter of sons and wealth and wife and husbands and parents, but what use are they? They're just like soldiers that are like bubbles in the waves of the ocean. They come up for a while and then fall under and go into non-existence. And that's my existence under such shelter. My only desire is to chant and hear and remember and engage in serving the lotus feet of Nandanandana. I want to engage in the nine processes of devotional service, surrendering myself fully, becoming his friend. All relationships are within that service to Srimati Radhika, including friendship in the highest degree, and I want to engage in those processes. This song was sent by Govindadas to Srila Jiva Goswami in Vrindavan, who was so pleased by hearing the song, and he blessed Govindadas that you are qualified to write Vaishnava songs in glorification of Krishna and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So I bless you that you'll be able to do that and purify the world, and please send me those songs as well.
Ativiram dhasya jnanan jana salakaya chakshurun militam jena tasmai se gurave वंचा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरत्विषये गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो यं प्राप्तजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विराकान्तर्याजुभाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोऽभिनेतुं तं सर्वभूतहृदयम् तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नय माम च as in the lotus feet of my Diksha Guru, Om Vishnu Pad, Sri Srimad Bhakti, Veda, Bhakti Pragyan Kishore Goswami Maharaj. And same into the lotus feet of my Diksha Guru, Om Vishnu Pad, Sri Srimad Bhakti, Vedanta Swami Maharaj. We are explaining Srimad Bhagavat, first shloka, very high philosophical explanations are coming. I am fearing that all our understanding or not, otherwise will change my subject and I will do very sweet pastimes of Krishna. But, so, the Rishi Saunak and others asked Sutta Goswami, the disciple of Sukadeva Goswami, you know everything. You have read Srimad Bhagavatam, all literatures, Vedic literature, Mahabharata, Ramayana, Puran, Upanishad. Now, we are very shraddhalu, having so much strong faith. Please tell us in a very easy way that how our soul will be happy, eternal happy. And then he told, Sabai punsaṁ paro dharmo jato bhakti rathok kaje ahet tukkab davhitāja bhakti pūrṣa. We have explained all these things. Especially we explained anna vilāsita sunyam jñāna karma adhyana pritam ankullena krishnānusīlanam. This is the highest definition of bhakti. We have explained also all these things. So if anyone will do bhakti like this, Vishuddha bhakti, giving up all worldly desires, sense gratifications, no mixture of jnana, karma, yoga, tapasya, astrology and other things, continuous, unbroken steam as a flow, day and night, all time, indiya anugatya, realized and rasic Vaishnava, then what will be Vasudevi? Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojita Janayate Asu Gyanam Vairagyam Gyanam Prajayadukha. It is so that hearing in this process, doing bhakti, then detachment for worldly things will so become. And all kinds of tattva gyan, sambandha gyan, prema bhakti, praj bhakti, all will come. If you are chanting name, if you are worshipping so much day and night, hundreds of Thakurji, doing so many things, but if you have no really Shraddha to hear Harikatha, to taste in Harikatha, then what will be? After some time your worship will go away. Your chanting will go away. Your all activity will go away. And you will give up Bhakti Guru. So first, by hearing from any bona fide Guru, a taste in hearing Harikatha should come. And that is why in Sravanam Kirtanam first has been told, Sravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam. Give preference to this. If Harikatha is going on and any superior Vaishnava is telling Harikatha, speaking, give up all these things, chanting and going parikrama to Govardhan and Vrindavan and all. Give up all the activities. It will be later on. First here. If Gurudev or higher class of Vaishnava are telling Harikatha, don't chant. Concentrate your mind in Harikatha. And what may be the result? Very soon, Srinivatam Swakatha, Krishna Punya Savana Kirtana, Hiddantastho Jabhadrani Vidhano Suhit Satam. Oh, he is good. By sitting, you can do it. If you like to see.
Should I sit?
It will be difficult to see you.
Like Putana. Om Jnanati Mirandasya Jnananjanashalakaya Chakshurum Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Vancha Kalpaturubhascha Kripa Sindhubhyaiva Cha Patitanam Bhavane Bhyo Vaishnavi Bhyo Namo Namaha. So Srila Gurudev is introducing, of course, from the first shloka of Srimad Bhagavatam, this important invocation shloka, and he has also led up to the sequence of shlokas which we find in the second chapter of the first canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. It is prefaced by the verse which Srila Gurudev just mentioned, describing what is the highest dharma, what is paradharma. Savaipung samparo dharmo yato bhakti radhoksha jay ahaitukiya pratihata yayatma suprasiddhi. This is the definition of paro dharma, as Gurudev is also connecting that verse with the definition shloka of uttama bhakti, pure bhakti, which is written by Srila Rupa Goswami, anya bilashita shunyam jnana karma dhyanavritam. Most of us have heard that shloka many times, being in this sangha. So, Srila Gurudev is saying that when someone comes in connection with hearing this transcendental message, then it is very powerful, the effect that this message will have on the listener. He has come to this shloka, Shrinvatam Svakata Krishna. Just prior to this shloka, however, there is another shloka which is telling Shru Shru Sho Shradhanasya Vasudeva Kataruji Syam Mahatsevaya Vipra Punya Tirta Nishevanat. There, as Gurudev is saying, when someone has Shraddha, when someone has faith in hearing this message, Shradhanasya, those who are coming and hearing with open heart, as our Srila Prabhupada told in his purports to these verses, he said with the mood of submissive oral reception. He coined that phrase. That one is giving oral reception with a mood of submission to this message. So that means Shraddhanasya. So, Vasudeva Kata Ruchi. Then comes taste for hearing this transcendental message of Vasudeva Kata. The topics regarding Sri Krishna and all of his incarnations and pastimes, Vasudeva Kata Ruchi, taste will come in that association. So then the Srimad Bhagavatam tells this very beautiful sequence of shlokas, which describes how by hearing this message, a progressive effect comes in the heart of the listener. And it begins with this shloka. Shrinvatam svakata krishna punya shravana kirtana hridyantaksto yabhadrani vidunoti suritsatam. By hearing Shrinvatam svakata krishna, that means the transcendental narrations of Krishna Katha, topics about Krishna and also topics spoken by Krishna, like his own words in the Srimad Bhagavatam and in the Bhagavad Gita. So, Shrinvatam Sokata Krishna Punya Shravana Kirtana. This hearing and this chanting is called Punya. It is very exalted. It is beyond any other topic of this world, and it has special power that no other topic has. What happens? When Krishna, who is within the heart of everyone, sees that this person is hearing about me, he is hearing my transcendental topics, then Krishna himself, who is situated in the hridi, in the heart of every living being, he begins vidunoti. He begins the process of cleansing that person's heart. Because why? Because he is Suhrit Satam. He is the well-wishing friend of every devotee. And he wants to help every soul. So therefore he begins to act within the heart by cleansing all the abhadras, the inauspicious things, the unwanted things which are hindering our progress and being able to understand and experience our relationship with Krishna. So then, as a person continues progressively hearing, then nashtak prayeshu abhadreshu nityam bhagavata sevaya. What happens is, he begins to perform this practice of hearing about Krishna nityam bhagavata sevaya, regularly. And he serves the Srimad Bhagavatam, he serves this message by properly honoring and respecting and developing an attraction and taste for it. But also he serves the Bhakta Bhagavat. There are two types of Bhagavats. Granta Bhagavat, the Srimad Bhagavatam, and Bhakta Bhagavat, the person Bhagavatam, who embodies the very teachings of the Srimad Bhagavatam. So, when he begins to serve these two, constantly, Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya, then Nashtak Prayeshu Abhadreshu, by this hearing process, almost all of the abhadras start to become vanquished from the heart. And then, Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki. Then, pure bhakti begins to flow within that person's heart. Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki. And this bhakti becomes steady. Naishtiki bhakti. he comes actually to the stage of nishta. Now anartha nivritti has taken place. And most of his anarthas, not all of his anarthas, but most of them, they have been removed from the heart. And then, tada rajastamo bhava kama lobhadayaschaye. Then the effect of the modes of ignorance and passion, tamagun and rajagun, they are coming into the heart of everyone. All the conditioned souls are hindered by the effects of these two lower modes of nature. And they manifest in the heart in the form of lust, anger, greed, envy, illusion, like this. So when, by this process of cleansing the heart, these effects of passion and ignorance become removed, then cheta etair anavidham. His consciousness now becomes uncontaminated and unaffected by these lower modes. And then stitam sattve prasidati. Now he becomes situated in sattvagun. In sattvagun only can one realize and understand this transcendental message. When the modes of passion and ignorance are prominent, then this cannot reflect properly within the heart. It cannot truly influence the depths of the conditioned soul's heart. So when he comes to the stage of sattvagun, where rajagun and tamagun are mostly removed, then he now becomes prasidati. He becomes very happy and satisfied. Then evam prasanna manaso bhagavad bhakti yogataha bhagavat tattva vijnanam mukta sangasya jayate. So now his evam prasanna manaso, now his mind becomes very pleased when he is performing bhagavad bhakti yoga, fully absorbed 24 hours daily in hearing, chanting, remembering, just like this song that we just sang. Shravana kirtanam smarana bandana pada sevanam dasyare pujana sakijana atma nivedana govinda dasa abhilasare. He is constantly absorbed in the performance of ninefold bhakti yoga, and his mind becomes very pleased. And then bhagavat tattva vijnana, he realizes, he gains transcendental vijnan, direct perception and realization of bhagavat tattva. In other words, the absolute truth, as we have been discussing, as Gurudev has been teaching us from the first shloka of Srimad Bhagavatam, all these transcendental realities of the Supreme Lord and His transcendental potencies and energies, and one's own relationship with Krishna, and realization of one's position as a tatastha shakti jiva soul, who is the eternal servant of Krishna, jiver swarup hoy krishner nityadas, then this becomes realized within the heart. And mukta sangasya jayate, he becomes liberated. Mukta means freed. He becomes freed from the false association of this material world, the kusanga, the bad association of this material world, all the attachments to the temporary objects of this world. And then his heart, which is tied by a knot very tightly, keeping him bound in this material world of illusion, vidyate hridaya grantis. Now that hridaya granti, that knot in the heart, becomes pierced. And chidyante sarva samshaya, all of his doubts.
What is hridaya granti?
Yes. Hridaya granti means janasya mohoyam aham mameti. That he is thinking that I am this material body and everything connected with this material body belongs to me. But there is probably some higher meaning which you should reveal to us.
Attachment about worldly things.
Yes.
Mama. Aham, mama, and other things. This attachment is hridaya granti.
So then, final words in this sequence of shlokas, kshiyante chasya karmani drishta eva atmanishvare. So, the chain that is binding us, this chain of karmas, which keeps us completely bound within the cycle of birth and death, and all the sinful reactions and also pious reactions, which are coming, which have been accrued from many lifetimes, Chiyante chasya karmani. This sequence and this chain, it becomes terminated. And drishta eva atmanishvare. Then he begins to understand that Supreme Lord Sri Krishna is Ishvara of the Atma, of the Jiva soul. He understands and he has direct drishta, some darshan of this truth. And at that time, he fully surrenders at the lotus feet of Krishna as his eternal servant. Hare Krishna.
I think these slopes Pratham Skanda Dvitiya chapter selected a slope and whole Bhagavat is only explanation of these. These are the essence of whole slope, whole Srimad Bhagavat. Try to understand all these things and try to follow. Especially, we should know Nasta prayesu abhadresu arhidyantasto jhabhadrani abhadrani abhadrani and also hridaya granthi sarvasansaya, all are abhadrani. What are they? These are anarths. First we should know what are these anarth are. And then by Harikatha hearing, Krishna will come and purify your heart, all will go. You should realize what are these anarths and are you covered with these anarths or not. Realize this. So, Ashram Maharaj will explain what are these anarths.
Om Jnana Timirandasya Jnanam Jana Shalakaya Chakshur Militam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. So, Srila Gurudev has ordered me to explain what the different anarthas are. In Sri Bhajan Rahasya, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he's explained that there are four divisions of anatta. That first, there's Tattva Brahma. That the living entity, as has been explained, is Jivara Srupa Hoi Krishna Nita Das, is an eternal servant of Krishna. But coming into this material world, then there's Krishna Bulisayji Banadya Bahimuk, Ataiva Mayatar Deha Samsarduk. The living entity, turning away, becomes whipped by the material energy, by Maya Devi. So, coming to this material world, then he undergoes this anatta of Brahma, means illusion, that he's an illusion about his real identity. This illusionment, it has four further divisions. First, is illusion Jiva Brahma, the living entity, not understanding who am I, that I'm spirit soul, I'm part and parcel of Krishna. Second is illusionment, being illusioned about the process of achieving the supreme goal. What is the sadhana? Then the third is being illusioned about who is the Supreme Lord? Even those who are born in India, then they will have so many conceptions that Lord Shiva is supreme, that Lord Brahma is supreme, that Durga is supreme. And even if one comes and is understanding that, oh, that Krishna is supreme, but then there may be still some vague understanding that, but I can worship Lord Nrisingadev, I can worship Lord Narayan, that all the same, all are equal. That according to Tattva Siddhanta, that yes, all the same. But according to Ras Vichar, then Krishna's Ete Chamsa Kalapumsa, Krishna's Tu Bhagavan Swayam. He's the original Supreme Personality of Godhead. And there is distinction. So not understanding the position of Krishna in relationship to his expansions, then this is another form of illusion. And then the last illusion is when one is misguided and takes some false, some path other than bhakti, like the path of the Mayavadis, which is their goal is to merge into the impersonal Brahman. So this is the first type of anatta, illusionment. Then the second one is asat trishna. Asat trishna means that one has some trishna, thirsting for the temporary things of this material world. So the living entity falls into this material world and identifying with the body as the self, then ultimately he's going to, he or she will identify with the different sense objects of this world as means of enjoyment. So this also has four divisions. Being thirsty or being greedy to enjoy things on this plane, this earthly plane. The second is when one goes beyond this gross type of enjoyment, then maybe one may enjoy or may desire enjoyment on the heavenly planets or of a heavenly delight. Then third, one may desire mystic perfection. And then the last type of thirst for things of this temporary things is impersonal liberation. So that's asat trishna. Then the third, the living entity may take to the process of sadhana. But in the beginning, the living entity, the kripa devotion, is weak. And the symptom of that weakness is called Hridaya Dubalyam, or weakness of heart. This weakness of heart also has four divisions. That first, there's kutinati. Kutinati means duplicity or hypocrisy. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur, he said that when one comes to the path of bhakti, that it is better, having come to the path of bhakti, that it would be better for one, this is a bit of a strong statement, it would have been better for one to have taken birth as a worm or any other lower species than to come to bhakti and to cultivate hypocrisy or duplicity. So this kutinati is very, very dangerous. That Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur has said, sarlata e vaishnavata, that simplicity is Vaishnavism. That in the beginning and always, we should always cultivate simplicity. That we should approach, especially Gurudev, with an open heart. That we should not come hiding. That everybody's coming weak with anattas. But we should not try and pose to be in a position that we're not. But rather, very, very humbly accepting our position with our anattas and crying and praying to Gurudev for help. That actually, without the help of Guru and Vaishnavas, then we have no saving grace in this world. This is simplicity. And to act in a way other than this is duplicity. Then next, So kutinati. Then next is pratishta. Pratishta is designed for name, fame, adoration. It's stated that this anatta is most subtle, that one may even achieve the stage of going towards bhakti, but still this pratishta, this may still be lingering there. This desire for name, fame, position is stated kanaka kamini pratishta bhagini tadyache e vaishnavata, that one may very easily give up kanaka and kamini, desire for wealth, gold, or desire for the opposite sex. But this giving up pratishta, desire for name, fame, distinction, adoration, that this is very subtle and very difficult. And that one can only give this up by taking shelter of advanced Vaishnavas and crying for Gurudev for help. Then Matsarya. I'm skipping one. Kutinati, pratishta. Okay, so Matsarya. Matsarya means envy. That this anatta, it is stated by Srila Narottam Das Thakur that you have six enemies: lust, anger, greed, envy, madness, illusion,
Lust, anger, envy, greed, madness, delusion.
Six.
You have six enemies. And amongst these six, that they can be dovetailed in Krishna's service. That, and I won't go into different ways that these five can be dovetailed. But one will not be tolerated at all. And that is envy. That envy is not tolerated in the association of Vaishnavas. Krishna does not tolerate this at all. So this at all costs should be given up. So these are three categories of the anattas. And then the last is aparad. Aparad means offense. And this is very, very grievous. Especially, let me see, the four divisions are first, save aparad. Offense to in worshipping the deities. Then there is Namaparad. And amongst Namaparad, then especially we should be careful about Vaishnavaparad, making offense to Vaishnavas. That one we may have anattas and so many sinful desires within the heart or material desires within the heart, but these are like dust in the heart. But when one makes aparad, especially Vaishnava aparad, and the one aparad which is most unforgivable is guru aparad, then this is like a thunderbolt which comes and obliterates whatever devotional activity that we've performed. So it said that we should be very, very, very careful about aparad, especially nam aparad. So there's seva aparad, nam aparad, and then there is aparad to chitkan, to other living entities. That we may be very careful about making aparad to Vaishnavas, but we should also be very careful about not offending any living entity, you know, by our body, by our mind, or by our words. And then the last is tadiya, those related, such as the holy Dham, Ganga, etc. So these four categories of anattas by four, then these make 16. So we should be very careful to... It's natural that anattas will be there within. But one important point is how to quickly come through the stage of having anattas and becoming free from the anattas. And the secret is sadhu sangha, to take association of high class devotees. But how do we take association of sadhu sanghas? As is stated by Maharaj, shushusho shradadanasya vasudeva kataruchi syan mahat sevaya vipra, by serving those Vaishnavas with body, with mind, and especially with heart, by giving our heart to those Vaishnavas, and by their mercy they will protect us, and these anattas can be eradicated from the heart.
Kotinati, he called. What is the meaning of Kotinati? Don't criticize anyone, especially Vaishnavas. Once, Prabhupada sent some devotee to preach in West Bengal, East Bengal, or anywhere. They preached very well. And they wanted to establish a preaching center there. They asked Prabhupada, what should we do? Oh, you can. I will be very happy if you will have a preaching center there. Prabhupada told that if you are ready, I am coming with so many devotees. And they were day and night preparing that preaching center should be so good and fine, all kinds of equipment will be there. And Prabhupada will be there and very happy. Also, they made a temple. Deity was also ready to be established by Prabhupada. On the next day, he came. Then, he saw everything. He became very happy. Then he told that, oh, that brahmachari, where is he? Who came first here and tried so much? Where he is? Then they told that Prabhu, he was very good brahmachari, but he was entangled to a lady. So we whipped him so much that he fled away from this place. Oh, I don't want to establish a center, preaching center, and to establish deity and anything. You know that from this world, we spend hundreds of gallons of blood to bring a person from Maya clutches. Anyhow, and if he is somewhat done, missed it, it would have been washed away by chanting and serving Hari Guru Vishnu. And you have chastised and he has fled away. I don't want to make a center. Search him and bring him to me. Then I will be here, otherwise I will go. All became very anxious. They were searching here and there. And then Shripad Madhava Maharaj, at that time name was Hayagriv Brahmagriv. He told that I may discover him. And he anyhow discovered and went there and he begged, apologized to that brahmachari who was entangled with that lady, any lady. Oh, excuse me. Prabhupada is very unhappy with us. Please come. Oh, he began to weep. Prabhupada is very merciful. I was here, serving here in a watch company. But I was not really happy. I wanted to return, but how can I show my face? So I was not returning. But Prabhupada has called. How endless mercy more than Krishna. At once he come running and weeping and fell flat on the Lord's feet of Srila Prabhupada. And his all anaths washed away in a moment. So you should always don't criticize anyone. If devotee know how, even a worldly person, it has been told in Srimad Bhagavatam, Svabhava Karmani, Svabhava Karmani, none in this. No prasansya. Don't glorify worldly persons anything good or bad. If you are doing, all bad activities will come in you and will be spoiled. So, in bhakti, you know Bilva Mangal, you know Srila Prabhupada, that I told, I know my Gurudev. To bring a person from Maya clutches is very, very hard. If that thing, any attachment lasts, it will go away very soon. If he chanting, remembering, listening Hari Katha, so you should not, you should be very careful about that. Don't criticize devotees or undevotees, anyone. First try to pure yourself, how you are. Is there any lust in you? All kutinatis you are not. Be anxious for that, be worry for that. Don't worry for others. Guru is responsible, Krishna is responsible for that. You cannot do anything, then why you have no right to criticize him? That is for all, be very very bad.
Krishna told if someone is doing my bhajan, but he did any bad karma, like entangled with ladies, anything, then none can punish him, none can criticize him. I shall purify my devotee and junk could not punish him. Yeah. I right reserve with me, none can criticize him, none can make any offense, none can punish him. I will do by myself. I shall enter his heart and cleanse his heart. None can do that.
Good, Praman. Now, it has been told here, Bhaktir Bhavati Naishthiki. So what is your Naishthiki Bhakti? Then Nishtha. Oh, Madhav Maharaj will tell about Anaishthika Bhakti. Six kinds of.
Hare Krishna. Onga Gyana Timiram Dhasa Gyananjana Salakaya Chakchuru Unmritam Jena Tasmahi Sri Gurave Namaha. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Try to listen all carefully, and what you are hearing, keep in your heart back, and try to follow.
So, you have heard from Sripad Padmana Maharaj and Sripad Ashtam Maharaj, especially Ashtam Maharaj explained about anarthas. Srila Gurudev ordered me about explain anisthita bhakti. Just you have heard about nishtha. Nashta prayesu abhadresu nityam bhagavata sevaya bhagavati uttama sloke bhaktir bhavati naishthiki. Prior to that, one stage called anisthita means unsteadiness in bhajan. Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur has explained in his Madhurya Kadambini. These are six types. You have to cross these six process, then you can reach in nishthita bhakti. What is that? The first one, utsaha mayi. Second one, ghanatarala. I shall explain one after another. Utsaha mayi means too much enthusiasm. Srila Vishwanatha explained in his Madhurya Kadambini, just like one small kid sent to school by her parents. In school he saw one book, A for apple, B for bat, C for cat, D for dog, very happy. And he came back, just like he conquered the whole world. And his parents are patting him, oh, you did very nice, extremely. You are the best intelligent boy in the whole world, like intellectual giant. Oh, I'm very happy. When gradually, his teacher is giving home task, and sometime after few days, he could not maintain home task properly, then he became fat. Oh. And teacher rebuked him. Then he said, oh, I should not go to school. Mother is telling, oh boy, please get up. Now time has come, your bus is coming to take you to school. No, I will not go. Why not? He is not telling to mother. Why? Because he rebuked by teacher in school. Just as if you not do, then he expelled you from your school. So don't like to go. So first was too much enthusiasm. Even mother calling before from his bed, he get up and being ready to go to school. Now, ghanatarala, first enthusiasm. In same way, in spiritual life, when someone got Harinam,
Then he became very happy.
Because Gurudev tells
him, if you do bhajan,
nam, then everything your be successful. Life.
All your fulfill, all your desire will be fulfilled.
Very soon Krishna prema will come.
So. So you stop other thing and only chanting. Is this utsahamai, too much enthusiasm. After that, because he has not realized anything, he has not so much taste now. Oh, then headache come and become some tired. Then how much round he was chanting in beginning, he less than 1/4 he is doing. Sometimes stop. Why? Because there is no taste. So it is called ghana tarala. Sometime doing so many rounds and sometime less. One devotee want to take second initiation came to me. I asked him, how many rounds you are chanting a day? He told sometime 4, sometime 30. Why? Why is 4 and sometime 30? Very hard for me to chant regular the all rounds every day. Or sometimes stop. So this is called ghana tarala, sometime thick, sometime thin. Then Buddha Vikalpa, now in dilemma, what to do? I have heard and I have seen that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave up his mother, his wife, all society, and ran away from home and took renounce order. And he attained Krishna Prem, and how to attain Krishna Prem, he taught the whole world. What shall I do? Shall I be a renounced person or I will be a householder? Oh, we have heard and we have seen other day the drama of Bharat Maharaj. What he did? Yodhuspajan Darasutan Surid Raja Hridis Visa Jubaiva Malabat Tatta Jyottam Sloka Lalasa. Very hard to get rid of wife and small kids when you are young age. If you go anywhere for your job or business, when you paid up and then come back, if your small kids, Papa, I have a candy please. Hearing his broken language, you'll forget all your sufferings. So in young age, to give up young wife and small kids, very hard. And if you have too much wealth, then very hard. Bharat Maharaj, what did? Give up all these things like a stool and come to do bhajan. We have seen Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, our Gurudev, Param Gurudev, all did same thing. Sir, what shall I do? Oh, no. I could not be renounced order. Why not? We have seen in the time of Mahaprabhu, almost all his devotee was householder. Time of Krishna, almost all associates as householder. If I go, then what will be destiny of my mother? Ahome pitaro vriddhau. Oh, who will take care of my old mother and father? Who will take care of my stri? Who will take care of my young child? I should not go. So when this dilemma is coming in mind to do bhajan, how I will do bhajan? This stage called Buddha Vikalpa. Means in dilemma. Could not fix his what mind, what to do, what not to do.
What to do, where to live in house, whether I should be renounced or vanprastha, what should I do?
Yes, implication, decision.
Decision.
Then, taranga rangini, visaya sangara means, visaya means material thing, sangara means fight. When you are doing bhajan, so many visaya will come to you. Oh, I don't want to take all these things. Sometimes you are fighting with visaya, material, mundane thing. Sometimes you overcome, sometimes you take over by visaya. So it will come when you are doing bhajan, visaya sangara. Taranga rangini, niyamakshama. Niyamakshama means the two types. Niyam agraha, niyam agraha. You have taken some vow to maintain this rule and regulation. I must chant 16 rounds before my breakfast. You are doing this, you are chanting, your Gurudev came to you or an elevated Vaishnavas. Why should not get up? Why is this rule? How I can give this up? But it mentioned in scripture, if your, especially your Gurudev come or any elevated Vaishnav, you have to give up all things, quit your all service, and please pray, pay him obeisances and serve him, please him, then can do others. Only by their causeless mercy, our pure name will dance on our tongue. Otherwise, not possible. If you neglecting Gurudev and Vaishnavas and too much attached for your rule and regulation, then it is called Niyam Agraha. Another one, Niyam Agraha. You have taken some vow but could not maintain properly, then called Niyam Agraha. So, Niyam Akshama. Maintaining rule and regulation but unable to do that. So Niyam Akshama. Now Taranga Rangini. When you are doing bhajan, then during bhajan, so many tests will come in your mind about mundane thing. Chanting Gayatri Mantra, mind went anywhere else. And testing. You forgot that in 9 mantras or 8 mantras, how many mantras you have chanted so far? You forgot completely. Maybe 1 hour have been passed, you don't know what you are doing. And where you are in this world or anywhere else? You forgot completely. This stage called Taranga Rangini. So when you overcome from these 6 anarthas, then Nishtita Bhakti will come. How will come? Sinnatang Sakatha Krishna, Punna Savana Kirtana, Hriddanta Stai Jhavaddani, Vidhunoti Srit Satam. So once, somebody asked our spiritual grandsire, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, how we can overcome from this anartha up to much last? Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj replied, you listen Ras Lila, then it will go away very easily. Then how we can reconcile with this law? Sinnatam Sakatha Krishna, we have heard from Gurudev other day that what is that we have heard? Why Mahaprabhu came? Samarpaitu munnata jalasan sa bhakti sriyam. To want to give the beauty of his own bhakti. Who is Krishna's own kith and kin, entourage of Krishna? Swamin Siya Srimati Radhika. So Krishna want to distribute the beauty of Radhika's bhakti. That means bhavallasrati or manjari bhav. In the same way we explain this slok. Srinnatam sakatha Krishna. You have to listen to Krishna's own katha, so means own. Who is Krishna's own? Srimati Radhika is Krishna's own. So what pastime took place with Radhika and Krishna, we have to listen that. Srinnatam sakatha Krishna. Why? Punna savana kirtana. It is very auspicious for listening and to do kirtan. Hit karna rasayanam. It will be rasayan, very tasty for ear and heart. Then what will be result? Hiddantastai javadrani vidhunoti srit satam. And which anarthas we have, then it will wash out by hearing only. Without hearing, we could not enter in Nishtita Bhakti. So must we have to listen Harikatha from Srila Gurudev, his lotus leaf, or elevated Vaishnavas. Then we can properly achieve Nishtita Bhakti. If Nishtita Bhakti comes, then gradually we will develop, there is no doubt at all. Before Nishtita Bhakti, there are so many stages to fall down. When you come Nishtita Bhakti, then if you in good association, one will gallop all these stages very quick. None can stop you. But only one condition, do not any Vaishnava Parad. Hare Krishna. Bancha Galvataru Bhasya Kripasindhi Hare Krishna.
After this, no aparad. No Hridaya Dorbalya, no other any of the four. But it's still Samanartha there. Loy, Bhikshe, Pratipatti, Kasar, Adhashasya. And after that also, Ek Desh Vartani. We will gradually explain all these things. So we'll have to get so many stages. Krishna Prem is not so easy, especially Braj Gopi Bhav. Anyone had to, or thousands and thousands of births you have passed, and then in this stage you have come that you are hearing Hari Katha. And if you will miss, everything will be missed. And if you are really following, then gradually you will go. So we will explain all these things. In Srimad Bhagavatam, it has been told, Kathai Maste, Kathita Mahi Asam, Pitaya Lokesu, Jasa Pareyusam, Vigyan Vairat Vivikshaya Vibho, Bacho Vibhuti Natu Par. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is telling, oh, so many kings, like oh, Puru, like Uttam Pak, his brother, Priyabrata, Prithu, so many kings, they passed away. Prithu, Purarva, also many powerful kings. Sukadeva Goswami is telling that I have explained in this Srimad Bhagavatam. Why? No Paramartha. In this no Paramartha. But what is there? Vairagya Vivikshaya. What became of that? What became of them? They could not be happy. We have heard about Puranjan Upakhyan. He was not satisfied with his wife and children and kingdom, and how he was cheated. We know so many stories. Prachin Varhi, Narada is teaching him. So this Upakhyan has been told that you should realize and barrage detachment from worldly sense gratification should come. If you are hearing Harikatha, chanting name, doing all the devotional activities, if Parag is not coming, then what it will be? So we should read all these things only for this. And 10th canto, especially, Lila Katha speed, first make ground level. And then here, so we will try to explain Hari Katha, Krishna Katha from 10th canto in the rest 3 days. Here, one day, past Anartha Nivritti. Only Anartha Nivritti we have done. And from tomorrow, we'll try to discuss about Krishna past shrines. Gau Premanande. No drama plays today? One? Oh, I cannot stay.